So you get your CSV file downloaded from the Banggood dropshipper, and you want to import all those products to Shopify. And in this video, I'll show you exactly how to do it using the Excelify app for Shopify. So here I have my Excelify app open in my Shopify admin, and here's my file. So what's important here is that the file name should contain the words Banggood and products, so that the Excelify knows that these are Banggood products. It can have also something like 1, 2, 3, 4 here, additional data, that's okay, but just it needs to include the Banggood and products. And then we just drag and drop the file into the Excelify app, and you see it recognized it as a Banggood format. That's a validation that really this is recognized as Banggood products. And here you see that it found 64 products in this file. And we could easily just press import, and it would import those 64 products there. But we will do a bit longer way through the way how you can change some data in the same file before importing. So that, let's say you want to set prices as you want and so on. For that, we'll do the dry run here in the options, so that essentially this will convert your file but will not import anything yet. So we press import and it's doing the dry run, and yes, now it's finished. And deliberately I wanted to show you how it is if you have something failed. So here we have one failed product, and then we download the import results file, and in that file we'll see that here at first you see that there is a product sheet in this Excel file. So these are the products, and here we have the handle, the title, and the command, which is update, so that if it will find the same product again in your store, it will update it, but if it will not find it, then it will create it. And so we generate the handle from the title, and we add this Banggood ID at the end, so that these are guaranteed to be unique handles. But of course you can figure out your own way how you want to generate handles for products. But so yes, so you have the title, the body HTML, which is converted also from the Banggood file. All the images are removed from the product description, and everything is made like nice and tidy, so that it looks nice in your Shopify store. And then there is whether this is a published, and published to what scope, the product type, the tags. The tags contain basically the categories and subcategories of the Banggood categories. You can, of course, again, that's why we did the dry run, so that you can change those as you like. Also, we are adding the, for example, this warehouse CN, which means that it's coming from the China warehouse. And with those underscores, if you know, you can use them as a group filters in certain themes in Shopify, that for example this category will become a filter group, and this becomes possible values, and the same with the subcategories. Again, the vendor is Banggood, but you can change to whatever you like. Then comes the image columns, like again, the image command merge will check if this image already exists for product, and if it does, then it will keep it, and if it doesn't, then it will add it. So you can run the same file importing several times, and if something will change, it will basically add those images. And here you can see that there are all the many images for the products. The image alt text, which is basically empty, but you can set any alt texts as you like. Then comes the custom collections column, which basically will add here, they are comma separated column names. Let me just make it bigger. These are comma-separated collection names. In this case, for example, this product will be added to automobiles and motorcycles and to this second custom collection, and so on. So these essentially will result in the same kind of collections as there are categories in the Banggood. This column indicates whether this is a top row. For example, if one product has several variants, like in this case, this one obviously has some several lines for different colors. So if you want just to find the first row to edit something, you can filter those by the top row. Then comes the variant columns, where we have decoded the options from the Banggood file and describing them as variants. Like, for example, here is the color, the different colors, and like usually that's a color, but there are more complicated cases. Like here there is a color and size combinations, and even more complicated, like for example, here is a color and type and with some values. Then comes the SKU, which is the basically the Banggood ID. So when you create the order which comes from Banggood, then you can send those IDs to the Banggood, and they will be able to fulfill that order. The weights and the prices and compared prices and the variant cost, which is for you to this is a specific field in Shopify, quite new, where you can essentially tell what was the cost for you, cost of goods. So in this case, you could easily adjust the variant price, like you want, let's say you want to do it double the original cost. You just make a formula here, like times two, and you copy the formula all the way down. So in that way, all your products will have the price which is double the cost, and you can leave them as formulas in this edited file. Just click save and you will be good to import them. And there is also some other variant attributes which you can change, whether this is a require shipping, of course it's true, whether this is a taxable. Then there is a variant image, so that it basically puts the first image of the product for each variant, because Banggood doesn't distinguish image for each variant, but at least there will be some images. And about the failed, remember there was one failed here, one was failed during the dry run, and here at the end there is a column which is the import result and the import comment, two columns. And basically, if you want to find all the failed rows and understand why they failed, you can just filter here to select only the failed rows and see. For example, here it says cannot parse Banggood options and something, and this means that we couldn't basically decode what's inside the Banggood file options. And in this case, you can just send us the two files, basically the original CSV file from Banggood and this converted file, and we'll fix this issue for you if you have it. Yeah, just let us know. And then next, what's coming is the meta fields, and those contain all the additional kind of fields that you can use in the Shopify store, and they all will be put in the Banggood namespace. For example, here is the category name, the category URL, which is the original URL for this category, and the subcategory name, the subcategory URL, and the product URL, in case you want to like afterwards reference and know where is this product actually coming from. By looking into this meta field, you can know that. And okay, that's how we do it. We edit this file, whatever we need, we save it, and then we close this file. Again, we can go back to Excelify app and import this already import results, the edited import results file. And of course, again, it will analyze it and it will see that there's a 64 products there. And this time we don't have to do a dry run. We want to do a real import. So we just press import and wait. And of course, while the import is running, you can do any other things. You can close this browser. You don't need to keep it open. You can shut down your computer, because everything happens on our servers. So realistically, you will have like hundreds of thousands of products. And so you can just come back whenever it's finished, and it shows, like, allow it to start with some items, and it will show you approximate remaining time, how long it thinks it will take to complete all this import. And also after the import, you will receive the email with the notification of how did it go. And while it's importing, I can show you here in Excelify in settings, you can configure the notifications to receive for example, for shop owner, for the started or finished jobs, or like you can add additional emails here in this box. At the moment I had it switched off so that it doesn't send me much emails. Right, so this import is almost done. Let's wait for it to finish. And actually, while it's working, you can already go to your Shopify products and start checking them out. And because those which are already imported, they are here, and you can review what, like, here are all the images, the variants, of course, the title, the description, everything is here. And also in the collections, since we are adding those products to those collections, you will see that those collections start to appear here. And whenever you look in the collection, you will see that those products are also here, like that. Okay, so we see that this import has finished, again with errors, because we had this one failed already. And if you will have any additional failed items, it will of course show you, and you again can download the import results file. And this time you can read proper comments, what actually happened in the Shopify with your items. Here, for example, it says that import comment is new, assuming replace for tags command, because we were setting the tags and we didn't have a tags command, so it always assumes replace, so that it replaces all the tags with the ones you are importing. So yeah, that's the same failed which we had earlier, but that's not a big deal. We can resolve it for you. Yes, so that's basically how you import those products from Banggood. Let us know what you think, what you are missing, and see you around. Bye.